We want a science of health and not a science of disease. Science of disease and its killing. We have grown sick of the science of disease. And the index of our health has deteriorated to an awful extent. Let us enter into new dimensions that are really positive. Let us learn to breathe more fresh air of wisdom. Let us learn to get exposed to more sunshine in the morning. Let us learn to enjoy more leisure while doing more work than we are doing now. Let us know the art of living than to know the industry of living. Let us know the art of living active instead of living busy. Let us know the education which keeps us young and active, irrespective of age. That wisdom which keeps us active until the last moment of the physical life, instead of living like a lifelong patient. Let us have an education which keeps us healthy. Let the student be made to understand that health is an outlook. And let the student be trained into the proper outlook of life. And the essential subjects that are to be educated into are to be given prominence. For example, the wisdom of the various crafts and their economic use and ecology in life. The economics that makes him not to make a misuse of nature's resources, not to exploit that which is given free to him, not to exploit the use of his own body which is given to him by nature, not to exploit his own thirst, hunger and sex that are presented to him for his own benefit and enjoyment. And let the student be trained into real science of administration, which makes him a real creator of little states, makes him a creator of self-sufficiency, makes him create groups that are self-sufficient, and makes him construct a network of such groups and test the real test of what is called the world goodwill. Instead of theorizing goodwill and using only the name of it, is there any sweetness in popularizing the name of sugar? Similarly, there is no sweetness in too much popularizing the name world goodwill. Let us live a life of world goodwill, and let us sponsor increasing the number of people who live a life of world goodwill. For this, let us train the students into civic life and civic science. Yes, a science of civics, a science of ethics, and a science of spiritual living, and a practical procedure of right relationship. Let these be the chief contents of what we call education. Unless we begin to live a life of self-confidence, unless we begin to live a life of faith and belief in others, we cannot boast of having an education. Without having an essential faith in the goodness of humanity, how can we call ourselves educated? Living with a life of a negative expectation of something horrible tomorrow, how can we call ourselves educated? Let the science of alignment be taught and practiced. See how the student is trained into the use of computers, the use of advanced microscopes and telescopes, and the use of a sophisticated camera, and if a camera or a microscope or telescope requires that much of training, what should be the precision and intensity of the training that is required to use the instrument that includes the physical body, the vital force with all the energy centers, the activity of the five senses and their objects, and the relationship of the mind with the five senses and the objects, and their relationships with what we call discrimination, which enables us to make a positive use of the instrument. With a laboratory training, which we call the discipline of the Eightfold Yoga Path of Patanjali, the training which gives us how not to misbehave with our food and drink, with our work and leisure, with our labor and rest, with our sex, with our friends and neighbors, with our family and relatives, with our colleagues in the office and in the club. So, the training that is required to make a better use of these aspects, not to make a misuse or overuse or disuse of these aspects. This is what is called the science of alignment of the human machine. This is what is required to bring the instrument into focus, to get it tuned with the society, with the state and the government, and with the nation and other nations, and being able to live an international life. This is real education, and without a true spirit of nationalism and internationalism, one cannot be really educated at all. And without a true national spirit, one can never dream of an international spirit at all. A fellow who cannot train himself into the fitness of his own little family, a husband who is not fit to understand his wife, a wife who is not pleased to understand her husband, a couple of parents who have not the maturity to understand their child, and a child who is not able to fit in with the parents in the home. How can these fellows fit in the family called society? How can such culturally ugly creatures can fit in a nation, into a nation? And how can we dream of these fellows boasting of internationalism? A fellow who is a failure with his neighbor, who has no proper relationship with his officer or his colleague or his subordinate, can be internationally a human microbe who eats the society and can never lead a positive life of internationalism. So this is the inevitable aspect of education in the modern age. It is not what we learn, it is not how much we have learned, it is not how many branches of technology we have learned, it is not how many languages we can speak or write, it is not how many countries we have touched in our globe-trotting, but it is how we behaved with everyone and how we behaved with ourselves. This is what can be called education, without which any amount of knowledge cannot be called education. One who is a great scholar cannot always be called a fellow of education. In the ancient scriptures, such a one is compared with a donkey carrying bags of sugar. The donkey knows only the weight of the bags and not the sweetness of sugar. So, one who knows the weight and heaviness of bundles of information need not essentially be educated. If one possesses a happy disposition of living happily and making others live happily, one can be called educated and otherwise not. This must be the test of education, an education of eternal values, and the eternity is what we call the modern age. So, let us turn towards the one university which we call the universe, and let us enter into the classroom which we call the human society, and let us search for the professors of our university who are the masters of wisdom. And presently we have the great professor, university professor of this universe, whom we call the Tibetan. Let us listen to his lessons properly, and let us preserve the freshness of the lessons and hand them down to posterity without going into the predictability of crystallization. Thank you all. Fit in, exactly. Not adapting. That is, the approach is fitness, not adaptability. Fitness is what is required. Getting adapted without fitness is not desirable. For example, we should be ready to do what others need and not what others want us to do. Think I should suggest it to you. If you know something, you should suggest it to me. And if we both of us do not know, let us approach a third person who suggests to us. If one can believe that God exists different from humanity, excuse me, I like to prefer humanity than God. That is what I understood from the teachings of Jvalkul. There is no God in its abstract sense at all. The God of expression comes from the God of the background. And since we are all existing as expressions in this creation, let us show our devotion to the God who has expressed in the form of humanity, and let us perform our duties to humanity before we begin to speak of God the absolute or the background. Until then, God never makes his presence felt to us, because he is a trickish fellow, more intelligent than the human being. God showered his grace any day only upon those who cared for the God in the form of human beings. Just as the sun showers his sunshine only to those who open their window for him. So, to speak of humanity with adoration is the same as speaking of God. And speaking of God, ignoring humanity, is escapism. And Lord Buddha warned us of this aspect, for which he is called atheist.